Hi guys, and welcome back to SITENG, where you can see all interesting civil engineering and site engineering stuff. And in today's video, guys, we're going to talk about five things you need to know before you start your career in construction, before you start looking for a job, and before you start thinking about getting in construction. So let's go, guys. First thing you need to know is that here in UK, you can actually do whatever you like, really, and only sky is the limit. That was the one of the reasons why I actually started this channel here, guys. Look, on this construction site, you can really go and start working as an engineer without your school, without your college. You can get your step up to being project manager. There's no limits, guys. It's only up to you. So this is very important thing, guys, to know that there is no limits, guys, really. And you don't have to do a couple of years of studies like I did myself to start here in construction site. And you can always start as a GP or as a steel fixer and then jump up slowly to have a look how the sites look, how it works, everything really. And then go to what you are really interested in after you're gonna see what's all happening here. So yeah, guys, that's the first thing. And then I'd say this is the most important thing because that shows you everything is possible. Second thing, guys, it's the CSCS card. Once you're gonna decide you're gonna start in construction, you're gonna need the CSCS card. And I'm gonna quickly show you how you can get it.
So that's the official website of CSCS here, and we're gonna look for the card, for the first card for us. And CSCS, that stands for Construction Skills Certification Scheme. And guys, the first card you're gonna be looking for, if you never had one, and obviously just make sure you are eligible to work here in UK and that you have a national insurance number. And then the next step, once you decide you're gonna go on site, you're gonna start working on site, you need a CSCS card, as without it, you cannot really start your work. And what we're gonna do now, guys, I just type laborer. That's really what we need. We don't need anything else. We just need a card, a basic card. Do we have a qualification? No. A professional body? No. It doesn't really matter. That's the red card. That's going to be our first card. This is provisional card for the half year, and then we probably going to be changing for some other cards. Dependent if you're going to get some qualification after you start working, your color of the next card going to be different, but probably if you want to keep a laborer card, it doesn't really matter. The color of card doesn't really matter. It's only a few sites. The people were checking if I actually got the engineering degree on the card, but that was, to be honest, that was only one job. It was Westfield YCT project, and I think it was all because they had some problems there before. And then once you're gonna get this card, you got access to site and you need it really. And the little tip for you guys is the most important thing is the test really. And once you got a test, your test is passed, the matter of getting the card is only 2-3 days really after you're gonna pay around £25 extra. You have to call and then they're gonna bring your card, but you don't have to really do it. If you want to keep your card for longer, you can actually wait to find the job. And once you find the job, you can call quickly and tell your new employer that you got a certificate for a CSCS card. And to be honest, and in most of sites, they still really accept the certificate, and then you're gonna bring your card in the next 2-3 days, as that should arrive to you. But obviously, if you don't mind to spend that £25 and start the clock ticking from when you paid it, and then you want to change quicker to your next one, that's no problem with that. And obviously, guys, everyone going to see the red card, they know you just fresh starter, so you can maybe get the green one if you want to especially cheat a little bit about your experience and stuff like that. And I found some other page. You're probably going to find hundreds of these pages. They offering quick course here, official CSCS green card course, lifetime qualification, and it's £90, so it's not that much, guys. And you can actually go for the laborer green card straight away, so that might be the better option. So, but that's the options, guys. Anyway, that's the CSCS card you definitely need. Once you decided you want to go on site, you want to start working, you just have to get one. So let's go to number three, guys.
Number three thing is the salary, guys, and the money you can make in construction. And this is very important, as construction is really demanding. And I know the work-life balance, it's maybe not the best here, but the money is really good here, guys. And once you start, you can actually check my video about the salary, but I'm gonna just jump quickly and double check, as the rates really going higher and higher, guys. And we can have a look what you can make now as a civil engineer, what you can make as a manager. And we're gonna try to find some information about the graduate, junior engineers, and maybe all this stuff at an entry level. So let's have a look.
So this is a civil library page, guys, and I'm gonna show you here quickly what the rates are now. And as you can see, setting out the engineer here, this is JRL. I told you that in my previous video, they always look for the engineers, setting out engineers. So you got here setting out 250 to 280 a day. We got another one 230 to 70 a day, 230 to 70, 220 to 40, 300 a day, 25 to 30. So the rates didn't really change maybe much from my last video. So you can have a look at my civil engineer salary video, guys, if you want to know more. But that's the really good rate, guys. And remember, the setting out engineer is actually entry level. So obviously, don't get me wrong, it doesn't mean that you're just going to start as a setting out engineer. But once you're going to know how to use the EDM, you're going to be hardworking and you're going to know the basic drawings, you can actually go for one of these roles, really. And it shouldn't take you much time to work as a junior engineer or to know all this stuff and start going for one of these jobs. And I'm just going to show you the senior engineer positions here. 23 to 27, 350 to 400, so that's actually quite good, 300 to 310. So yeah, that's very similar to my last video about the salaries. I just checked the graduate engineer here to show you what you can expect when you're going to be starting as a graduate. But I'm looking for structural engineers, 24, 26k. Graduate structural engineer, have you got anyone from construction here? Geotechnical, that's graduate civil engineer, 25 to 30k. So that's not very much, guys, but this is obviously graduate level. So about graduate, guys, I'm gonna try to do another video, as I got a friend one who's a graduate. He was working with me on that last job in Fulham, and I'm gonna ask him a few questions and I'm gonna try to do a video about it, so we're gonna know more how the graduate path looks. And then just maybe quickly show you the project manager salary here. So 350 to 450 270 320. So that depends obviously on experience and all this stuff, 400 a day. But this senior construction project manager, so that's the money. So as I said, guys, money here is really good in construction. It's hard work, it's demanding, but you can really find a good money here. Construction project manager, 350 to 450. And if you're gonna go for construction project manager career, you need to know that obviously you're gonna have more responsibilities, and you need a good experience to do it. And this is some other management skills, contrary to engineering. But typically project manager, they get also a bonus, which is a percentage of the money they making on the job. So that's really big difference between the engineering and then the project manager. So yeah, guys, let's go to number four then.
So thing number four, guys, would be the variety of courses available here in UK. And as I said in point number one, was everything is possible, guys, and sky is the limit, really. So you can get some course if you want to be setting out engineer, or if you want to do any other job, if you want to be the machine driver, digger, dumper driver, whatever, you can get a course, guys, and it's not going to take long time. Obviously it costs some money, but once you invest this, it's going to pay off. And trust me, I got the friends who are actually working as a dumper drivers, and they are engineers now. And so there is loads of stories like this, guys. And by the way, you see these nice curves on edge, and I'm going to do one video about this as well soon. So yeah, guys, I just want to jump quickly and have a look at what courses are available at the minute before I actually finish my own course. And guys, I promise it's going to be ready, but it's actually taking more time. And as I said, work-life balance in construction is not the best, guys, and working at least 10 hours a day plus the travel, you know what it is. It's not much time left to do the course, but I'm working on it, I promise. And as soon as it's going to be ready, I'm going to let you know, guys. So let's have a look at these courses.
So guys, as this is engineering channel, I found two courses here for site surveying and setting out. I think this is the similar one, setting out for construction. So I just typed in, really, you can find it easily online, it's not a problem. So you can see it's a 5-day course, it costs $895. These courses, you can think, guys, they're quite expensive, but once you're going to pay this money, they really pay off later, as the money you're going to earn later, as I said before in the salary section. You can get this money quite quickly back once you're gonna have this course. So who should attend? Suitable for training graduate engineers, construction managers, people with previous experience of setting up but not having been working overseas. So graduate engineers, training engineers, guys, that's our level here. But if you start, you're a training engineer basically. And so leveling, taping, you can have a look yourself actually what's in that course, what course is offering you, what you have to pay for them. I got another one here, this is CITB approved. So what does it mean, guys? If this CITB approved, that means we're going to probably go back to our CSCS card, and you're going to get a white CSCS card. We're going to be stating that you finished setting out in construction course, which is always good for your employer, really. So that's how it looks. So we got total station leveling set up over the point. So this is very similar, guys. So yeah, let's go to number five then.
And the number five thing, guys, it's the very interesting projects here in UK and especially in London, guys. You got very big, interesting projects. You got very good companies here. And I'm not saying about this project here. This is a typical residential. It's very good for the beginning of your career. It's very interesting as well. But here in UK, guys, especially in London, you can see the very big projects, very interesting stuff, the very deep basement, another interesting, the pure sleeveforms. And I'm going to show you a few things in a minute. So let's have a look at these projects and these companies as well, guys.
So guys, you probably heard of HS2, the great infrastructure project here in UK. There is lots of jobs, lots of opportunities there. For HS2, lots of company working for them really, and there is it works for years and very interesting projects. I got another one, Hinkley Point C, very interesting as well, guys. This Langerurk working there, doing the concrete. Have a look how many cranes are here. This is crazy really, and there's also lots of opportunities from the graduate level to all the senior and project engineering positions, so you can have a look there as well. Very interesting project, guys. One in a lifetime, maybe, you never know, but very good. And I'm going to show you one here, the Battersea power station, all this Battersea regeneration scheme here. It's loads of phases. As you can see, phase 2, phase 3, phase 4, so going to be 7 phases. This is also for at least 10 years project. I took a part in it. I worked in there for a few weeks. Also, there is many projects, guys, in Liverpool Street, Old Bishop's Gate projects, like this with giant props. You can see this article here with the propane. This has happened nearly everywhere now in the center of the city. They dig in the basement, 2-level basement, 3-level basement. This is really very interesting, guys. Look at this propane here. This is crazy, really. And these projects are very interesting also. So that's the thing, guys. It's very worth get into construction here in UK and especially in London, unless you're going to take a part in HS2 or the Hinkley project.
So guys, that'll be the end of this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope to like it. And if so, please don't forget to leave the thumbs up. Leave some comments below, guys. Follow my LinkedIn page. Pop in my Ko-fi page as well. And don't forget to subscribe, guys. This is very important to grow the channel, to make more people watching it and to make more people getting information, useful information for them, so we can make our community bigger and bigger and help ourselves. So yeah, guys, thank you again and see you next time.